Good morning. I'd like to welcome you to First Baptist Church for our Christmas cantata. If you will, as our tradition follows, stand up and take a few minutes to greet your neighbor beside us. Or across from you, or way away from us. If you consider yourself a visitor during the time that the offering plate is passed around, before the time the offering plate is passed around, fill out this little questionnaire here in the bulletin, hand that in to the offering plate so we can have a record of your attendance. A couple of announcements. This afternoon at 3 o'clock. There we go. We're going to Mark and Vicki Asher's house. They are going to have food for us and fellowship, and we will have shuttle runs from the church with the church bus every 30 minutes, I think.
Starts at
2:45. So you can catch a ride over there, fellowship, for 30 minutes, or an hour, or an hour and a half, whatever you want to do, and catch a ride back here to the church. Let's see, I have one more thing.
Christmas cards.
Get your Christmas cards so my father will not hound you. They're back there. He likes for you to get them before Christmas, preferably. But a lot of times we get them after Christmas. Any other announcements? I know Michael's got a few. Anybody else? Looks like you're up. All right.
Good morning. Speaking to the microphone. Just a reminder, our schedule this upcoming week of Christmas, we'll have Christmas Eve candlelight service on Christmas Eve at 5 o'clock, and that'll be here in the sanctuary. And then the next morning, we'll have a Christmas brunch, which will be a much more informal gathering with food, covered dish. Glenn and Vicki agreed to cook some pancakes and some other fixings. So there'll be plenty of food for everyone, and that'll be a time just to really kind of fellowship as a church family. We'll have some time of worship, but again, it'll be very informal. And that'll be in our fellowship hall. And then just a reminder, on Wednesday evenings, our normal Wednesday evening activities and schedule will just be canceled for the 25th, the 1st, and the 8th. And so we'll pick back up. After that. So just keep those things in mind. And we hope that we'll see you around during some of these services. If not, I want to go ahead and say to you, Merry Christmas.
All right, let us prepare our hearts and minds for worship today. If you will please join me in your bulletin for our call to worship. Christ is born.
Hallelujah.
Jesus is among us.
Hallelujah.
Shout with joy, give thanks, and sing.
Christ is born. Hallelujah.
Please take your hymnals and stand as we sing our offertory hymn, number 122, Good Christian Friends Rejoice.
Despair and fear. You visit us with surprising proclamations, and you intend for us good things. We thank you for your faithful and unending love, for sending signs of assurance, and for the gift of faith. Lord, all we have is yours. All that we may become and receive is in your hands. So let us give generously for the well-being of the world and for the glory of your kingdom. Use our gifts to bring comfort and justice to those in need, reforming and transforming the ways of our world for the sake of new life found in you, the Christ child, the life-giving Savior, the suffering servant, the living Lord, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Sing, 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 sing Joy to the world. The Lord has come. Joy has dawned. And today we celebrate God's great gift of love to all. But to Old Testament Israel, the hope of a brighter tomorrow, the promise of a joyful future, seemed an elusive dream.
For over 400 years, God's chosen people languished in bondage, longing for the day when the promised Messiah would come to deliver them. The prophet Isaiah had assured them that though they were people walking in darkness, a great light would eventually shine upon them.
A child would be born, a son given, and the government would be upon his shoulders, and that he would be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace.
Anguish and weeping might endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning.
A descendant of King David, was chosen by God to become the mother of the promised Messiah.
And it came to be that Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world. Mary and Joseph went up from the town of Nazareth to Bethlehem, the town of David. And while they were there, the time came for the baby to be born.
Mary gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in clothes and placed him in a manger, for there had been no room for them in the inn.
Keeping watch over the sheep on the Judean hillside outside of Bethlehem.
But this night became like no other night when an angel appeared to the shepherds and the glory of the Lord shone around them. They were terrified.
The angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for I bring you good news of great joy. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born. He is Christ the Lord. You will find the babe wrapped in clothes, in cloths, and lying in a manger."
Suddenly a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace to all.
The shepherds immediately left and soon found Mary, Joseph, and a newborn baby who was lying in the manger, just as the angel had told them.
After offering their humble gifts of adoration and praise, they hurried off to spread the word of all they had witnessed. The angelic proclamation, the newborn child in the manger, the wonder of two young parents embracing their miraculous roles in God's unfolding story.
All who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said. But Mary treasured up all these things and pondered them in her heart.
Jesus, joy of the highest heaven,
Christmas story is a story of joy. The Lord has done great things for us, and we are filled with joy.
Let the nations be glad and sing for joy.
The joy of the Lord is my strength.
Those who sow in tears will reap in songs of joy.
Shout for the joy to the Lord, all the earth.
This is a story of great joy. It is the fulfillment of God's promise to end the night of suffering with the dawn of redeeming life.
Receive her key.
Good Christian friends, rejoice
with heart, with soul, and voice, for Christ is born today.
Go, tell it. Go and shout it over the mountaintops. Jesus Christ is born.
Thank you.
last several weeks, we've had Hempstead Greens and Christmas musicals by our children and adults. And some of you have said, you know, that was one of your best sermons. I've done it again, folks. In all sincerity, thank you for leading us in worship, and thanks to all those who've led us over these last several weeks. As we've heard the songs of Christmas and the sounds of Christmas, and seeing the signs of Christmas, and heard the gospel proclaimed in a lot of different ways through our worship, it's been a really unique season. So thank you to all those. Let's stand and sing our hymn of commitment, number 119. His name is called Emmanuel. Say.
Amen. Amen.